Hi guys, very good evening to you. So in my another attempt to make you awesome in Excel and VBA, this video will talk about the VBA, and the target we have is how we can actually hide and unhide the sheets within a workbook, right? So this is something a kind of a code which we are actually going to create, and we'll then create a button where if we click, then all the sheets except for the sheet where I am right now, all the sheets are going to be hidden. And then with the another click, all the sheets, if you want, then you can unhide them, right? So what and before I go further, I just wanted to tell you, actually, in case if you're watching my channel for the first time, these are already the playlist which I have created, and you can go to these playlists, right? Just click on my name and then you will see all these series, four videos on the D count family and D max, D sum, what if analysis, dashboard making, very interesting and a very good respond on that. And you have all the playlist here, conditional formatting on MS Access, though that's just a one video, but you can check all the videos here so far. This is going to be my 99th video, and you can check the Excel VBA. If you want to watch all one by one, then you can click on this playlist. Otherwise, on the chart and pivot, you have the separate playlist, and for the Excel, you have the separate playlist, and for the advanced format cells and the arrays, the most powerful functions in Excel. If you talk about the Excel, only the Excel, not the VBA, then must watch this series. You will be delighted to know that Excel can do actually lot of wonders for you. So this is the video which I'm right now going to make. This video will be uploaded on this, and so far 25 videos will be uploaded then on the VBA, and watch all the videos. Absolutely, they will be very, very helpful for you. And so let's start this session without wasting a time. And so I'll simply go to the developer tab, and as you know, I'll go to the Visual Basic, and here we can create a module in case, but I have already created a module, so maybe I would like to use this. So now what I want to do is I would like my I would go ahead and make the program here. And so I'm gonna name this maybe hide sheets, press enter, and now you will actually start writing your code here, right? So if you go to my the other videos in the my playlist VBA, you'll come to know that we have used a lot of examples where we have used for each loop, right? For each loop. Now for guys who does not have any idea about the VBA, I must tell you actually that this is a loop which we actually use especially for the purpose where we want to do a lot of work, but without going to each and every sheet. And we just make our computer literate so much that it automatically runs on every sheet, and I will not have to actually give all the sheet addresses. For example, when you write the VBA code, you have to tell the Excel if you want to work on the sheet 2, you have to say that first select sheet 2 and then do some stuff there, and then go to the sheet 3, then you have to write the code again, sheet 3 dot select, sheet 4 dot select, sheet 5 dot select. And just imagine if you have 50-60 sheets, then it's going to be very difficult for you to write that kind of a code. It is going to be a very lengthy code. So we have this for each loop, wherein what we actually do is it's a predefined word for each, and then in this after for each, what you do is you write a single object, and then you write in, which is again a keyword, and then you write here the collection. A single object is going to be a part of a collection, right? What does that mean? That means if you're working on one workbook, then workbook is going to be treated as a single element, single object. But it is the plural for this, the collection word for the workbook would be obviously workbooks, right? Similarly, if you let's say if you're working on some cell like this cell, right? So if you want to work on different kind of a cells like this, all together, how will you do it? Then you say that for each cell in a range, the range is going to be collection word for that singular object, which is cell. Similarly, you say that for each chart in charts, for each pivot in pivots. You know, this is how the things go. And in our case, what we are exactly going to do is we are going to say that, first of all, what you need to do is you need to define a variable which has this class worksheet. All right, so worksheet, what does that mean? That means that this WS variable will hold all the properties and the methods of this WS. If you're not still not sure that what exactly I'm talking about, no problem, just watch this video and then watch all the rest of the 25 videos, especially on the looping system. You'll come to know I have given a very good amount of explanation there, right? But just to be very quick here, this worksheet exactly is a class. When you declare the objects, you know, you need to tell them that, you know, when you you can't work directly on the objects, you have to declare some variables, right? For example, this worksheet is a class, right? If you go to this object browser and if you type in here worksheet, this is a VBA word, this is a VBA class. If you let me just maximize this, now you check here that this is a class. Now when you click here on this class, you'll see that these are all the members of worksheet. So what does that mean? It means a worksheet can be activated, a worksheet can be auto filtered, a worksheet can be calculated from auto mode to manual mode and then back, you know, from manual mode to auto mode. A worksheet, you can do kind of a stuff that if somebody double click, then before double click what should happen, you know. So these are all the properties, the methods and the functions, right, which a class Microsoft Excel has defined, you know. So under this worksheet class, so what exactly it means? It means if you ever want to work on the worksheet, you'll have to define some variables indirectly, you know. You got to tell them that my variable is going to be equivalent to this class. So automatically whatever the properties and the methods this worksheet class will have, you know, through that variable you can access that, right? So for, let me tell you one thing more. So methods, what does that mean? Method means some action is happening, some action is happening, okay. And what does that property mean? Property is exact, the property means that, you know, a kind of you can say that property is kind of adjective, you know, for this, you know, the noun for the object, right? What does that mean? For example, if I say that I want to delete the workbook, I want to delete the worksheet, what does that mean? There is some action which is happening, right? So if some action is happening, then that is going to be a method. For example, when you add some workbook, this is how you write. Now this is a symbol which is for the methods, right? But this sign, you know, this envelope sign, as you can see here, the hand, you know, this is a property. So property means that if you want to know the name of a workbook, if you want to know the name of the sheet name is, let's say, you know, let's say index, the sheet name is, let's say, today's work. So what does that mean? That's exactly a property, that's the name of the object, right? So when we are actually going to declare these variables and we are going to give them these classes which are all already predefined in Excel, we ultimately tell telling the Excel that we will be now using these classes. Now if I put the dot sign, the separator sign, you see that whatever I was showing you in the object browser under this that worksheet class, they all are now, you can be accessed through this WS variable. Now this WS doesn't mean that it has to always be a, you know, WS, it could be your name as well. I'm gonna write my name here, right? And now if I say that Ajay dot, you see that this is really very amazing, you know, that I must tell you, VBA is actually very fantastic, you know, provided you actually know the basics and you know your concepts should be very clear on, and then you can do actually a lot of wonders in the VBA. So now I'm gonna just convert it back to WS, and now what we are exactly going to do here is we are going to run a loop, as I was telling you, for each. So I'll say that for each worksheet, now remember guys, I'm not writing here as a worksheet, I'm writing it here it as a WS. So for each WS in Excel worksheets, okay, that's the plural, you know, that's a collection word, and then you write the next, because for each will always come with the next. Now this is your code. Now between these two lines, whatever the code you will write, it will keep on repeating itself, right? So that's next worksheet. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to say that if this worksheet name is equals to macro, which is my first workbook, then what should happen? Let me put some indenting. Then it should happen that this workbook visible should always be visible. We don't want to hide that, right? Else what should happen? This is how you write your if condition. Else the workbook visible should be equals to Excel sheet hidden, right? You can even use the very hidden. I'll upload another video and explain you what exactly is the difference, but hidden means anyone can unhide it by going to the, you know, the shortcut key sheet and unhide, right click on the sheet, and very hidden means then he can't do that, right? He has to go to the developer mode and the Visual Basic environment. I'll upload the video, and that's a separate story altogether, so we'll talk about it in the next video maybe. And so this is how you're gonna write your and if function, right? Now let us try to run this code and let us see that what exactly is going to happen here. All right, so we started it. Now this, the name is macro, as you can see here, so obviously this will go to the then condition, which is this. So it is going to be make it visible as it is. So I am not seeing any changes here. The macro sheet is still here. And if the next, now it is again going to on the jump on the next sheet. So when you come here now you see that it is already a sheet 2 from macro. So that's what I was talking in the beginning, that these are the inbuilt features of the VBA. These are the loops wherein you don't have to do anything. You really don't have to tell Excel and the VBA that you got to select the sheet 2, sheet 3. It will automatically keep on going to the next sheet. So now you see that this name is not a macro, so it has skipped this then true condition, and it has jumped to the else condition, which is a false condition. And now this will be executed, and just keep your eye over here. I'm sure sheet 2 will be hidden then. Alright, so as you can see here, sheet 2 is no more here. You know, we have hidden the sheet. Now it'll go to the next worksheet, and this time the worksheet name is 3. So again it will go to the visible mode, and as you see here, keep your eye on this area, and you see that sheets are getting hidden. As you know every sheet is going to be hidden. So I'm gonna run this in just 1 second. If I press F5, this will not take even a second, and all the sheets will be hidden. Alright, so the macro is executed, right? So similarly, in order to do the reverse, if you want that your sheets should be unhidden, tomorrow when you come to the office, you want to see all the sheets, right? Before you again click on the hide sheet macro. So I'm just going to change this name to unhide, and this time what it'll do is we'll simply say that worksheet visible should be equals to visible, right? So we're gonna make all the sheets visible. That's it. Now just run this. As you can see in the Excel, all the sheets are coming back. Isn't it fantastic? I'm sure this is going to help you a lot in your day-to-day work, and I'm sure spending a time on this video is definitely going to give you a lot of enjoyment and a lot of learning, right? So what we need to do is, now let us quickly go to the insert tab, and let's go to the insert sheets and create two buttons. So I'm just going to copy this and paste this, right? So let's just click here, edit text, and say hide. And over here, what I'm going to do is unhide, right? Let's assign the macros. This is how we assign the macros. Assign macro. So I'll say hide sheet. All right. And then to this sheet, I'll again say assign macro, the macro which we have created for this, unhide, right? So I'm gonna click here, so nothing will happen because all the sheets are available. Just click on this and you can see that all the sheets are hidden. Just click here, you'll get all the sheets back. Amazing, right? So you can, you know, do a lot of stuff like this, and I mean to say, you can do this to n number of sheets. You don't have to do anything, the code is already prepared, because it is eventually, if I add some sheet 15 here, sheet 15 will automatically be taken because we have used for each loop, and then remember the next as well, right? So that's it for now, guys, and do subscribe to my channel if you haven't so far, and this is my email ID. Let me know in case if you have any questions, something is bothering you, or you know, terrifying you in Excel or VBA, or let it be MS Access database. I'll definitely go ahead and, you know, try to help you out and share the video with the, you know, whole world, right? So that's it for now, and I guess this is my 99th video, and very soon we are going to make a century. So it's actually a very, you know, good to see that, you know, so many subscribers day to day, you know, are getting connected with me, and so I'm sure you all are actually liking the videos, and I'm very much sure as well this is also going to help you, you know, a lot in your career, or maybe wherever the place you're working, or you, whether it's some of your official work or personal work. So with the hope again that I'll come up with another fantastic video which can further give you a lot of learning on Excel VBA, time to say bye, and we'll meet soon. Thank you so much, guys. Bye bye, take care.